Hi there. In this video, we'll be learning about the motion of objects when there are resistive forces present. Imagine a skydiver has jumped out of an airplane. They're in free fall and have a squirrel suit on. But when they open their arms and legs wide, they slow down their fall. Why is that? Let's learn about resistive forces. When objects move through any mediums, through any liquid or gas, they experience a resistive force that pushes against their motion. If the object is moving through air, there will be air resistance. If the object is moving through a liquid, then there will be viscosity forces that may resist the motion of the object. This resistive force always acts in opposition to the direction of motion, and as much as it's working against where you want to go, it's often super helpful. Resistive forces, for example, help boats to float on water and to sail with wind. They help airplanes fly through air, and they help stop you falling through the ground. But resistive forces behave differently relative to the size and weight of the object, the speed at which it's travelling, and the medium in which it's travelling. With small objects falling slowly through a gas, like air, or a liquid, the resistive force is directly proportional to the velocity of the object, but in the opposite direction. The formula to express this relationship looks like this. Here, R is the resistive force, B is a constant that depends on the properties of the medium, and V is the velocity of the object. The negative sign here shows that the resistive force is opposing the direction of velocity. Let's imagine a small pebble, which we'll say is a perfect sphere of mass m, falling slowly through a liquid. The force acting on the sphere is the gravitational force, F, and the resistive force, as we've learned, acts against it. If we take the resistive force from the gravitational force, we get the net force. Now let's substitute these formula for things that let us learn more. The force of gravity is equal to mass times the acceleration due to gravity. And we can replace R with BV from the earlier formula for resistive force. We also know from Newton's second law that net force equals mass times acceleration, where acceleration is the net acceleration of the sphere, downwards in this case. We can therefore combine all of these into MA equals MG minus BV, or rearrange to find acceleration as such. As time increases, the magnitude of resistive force increases, and this causes a decrease in the net acceleration. Eventually, the pebble reaches a point where the net acceleration is zero. This is known as the terminal speed, which is equal to mass times the acceleration due to gravity divided by the viscosity constant. The pebble is still falling when it reaches terminal speed. It's not accelerating. When we're considering large objects falling at high speeds through air, the resistive force R varies as half the drag coefficient D times the density of air times the cross-sectional area of the object times the speed of the object squared. This is the crucial difference between small objects falling slowly through a medium and large objects falling at speed. The resistive force for large objects moving at speed is proportional to the square of the velocity. Consider a large ball of mass m falling through the air with speed v, as shown in this figure. The net force acting on the ball will be the gravitational force, Fg, minus the resistive force. Remember, the force due to gravity is equal to mg, so we can combine this with knowledge of Newton's second law to find acceleration with variable resistive force. At terminal speed, the acceleration will be zero, so we can change our formula to this, and then simplify that formula into this. Don't assume here that resistive force is directly proportional to the speed of an object. For large objects moving at high speed through air, the resistive force is instead proportional to the square of the speed. Let's now work through an example. A 75-kilogram skydiver is falling through the air and reaches a speed of 52 meters per second. find the resistive force acting on the skydiver at this speed if their terminal speed is 60 meters per second. As this is a large mass falling through air at high speed, the terminal speed is the square root of 2mg over d ρa. The drag coefficient d from the terminal velocity expression is. When we're considering large objects falling at high speeds through air, the resistive force rho varies as half the drag coefficient d times the density of air times the cross-sectional area of the object times the speed of the object squared. In this video, we've learned about resistive force and terminal speed in two different scenarios. For more resources on anything physics related, check out the Chegg website. And don't forget to subscribe for more content. See you next time.